What's up, everybody? It's the one, the only, the Phenome, and welcome to part 23 of my massive video. We played through the Bring Down the Sky DLC. It took us a bit over an hour, and we dealt with some Batarian terrorists who were planning to crash an asteroid into a major human colony. We prevented that, but unfortunately the leader of the terrorists, a Batarian named Balak, managed to escape. Because he put us into a choice where we either chased him down or saved the hostages that he had. We went for saving the hostages, and Balak just left. So that's what happened in the previous part, but we also received a message from Admiral Kohoku. And he was informing us about Cerberus, once again, this Black Ops organization, and that A, it was behind the attacks on his men, who we found who were killed by a Thresher Maw, and that's one, and the other thing was that they were actually after him, but he wasn't concerned for himself, he just wants us to shut Cerberus down. Or at least shut down whatever stuff Cerberus has, and we can find. That's what we need to shut down. Right, let's quickly check the planets in the Yangtze system. This is where he directed us to. Protean data disk. Cool. What about this planet? Oh, that's a hot Jupiter, apparently. Okay, this. Right, large trace of beryllium. Okay, so the planet Binthu. Planet Binthu. This is where we're going to examine what Cerberus might have left. Considering it's Cerberus, and that's people, in that respect, I'll actually take a, I'll take a bit of a biotic setup. I'll give Garrus Vakarian a break. If this is going to be a multi-planet mission, since minor missions, if they go past one planet, then usually there's more to come. But, I'll give Garrus Vakarian a break, and, or not Rex, he can take a break if we have another one. So we have three research facilities on Binthu, and by the looks of things, Okay, I guess Garrus is not gonna get a run out. But he'll probably get a run out when we go to Pinnacle Station, which is the other DLC. About Pinnacle Station, that one will be pretty difficult to do. Because I remember my struggles the previous time. I'm not gonna go into too much detail. I don't want to spoil it for you guys. Are those towers? Yep, those are towers. Heavy turrets. Okay, we're good there. Let's get in there. Me and my sexy, sexy Colossus armor. Here we go with the creepy music again. Right, very empty. Very empty here. And we're gonna have Rex on his assault rifle and Liara with the pistol. And I'm not sure what I'll have actually. What are the?
I smell trouble.
Okay, they're gonna be coming to us. So barriers up. VR is gonna bring that guy up. That guy is down. Anyone else want some? Come on, people. Let's go. Oops. Alright, mind the sniper. To push that guy away. Oh, woman. research technician. Oi, where is he? Sabotage your weapons. Hey, I thought you were a research technician. Alright, so that's the threat eliminated in this lab.
Looks like Cerberus has other bases on this world, Shepard.
Yep, that's the way it looks. That's the thing to open the shields in the middle. And there's nothing else here, so yeah, it's basically just go in, eliminate the base, get out. Alright, that went well. I guess I'm underestimating the ability, the biotic abilities in the first game, but that's mainly because of the cooldowns. The cooldowns are just so long. I mean, look at this, recharge time 40 seconds. Warp 40 seconds. Master lift 40 seconds. Master throw 40 seconds. It's all 40 seconds. And you're gonna see the difference. Oh my god, I got heavy, another heavy predator H8. So I guess Ashley's gonna get some more. Oh my god, she's gonna basically become a battle tank. Man, she might even get tougher than Rex with that armor. But yeah, what I was about to say is, you're gonna see in the second game and the third game where the combat systems are they've been modified and upgraded, how much more fluent the gameplay feels if you're using your abilities, and you have to use your abilities. Here you can maybe deal with gunfire and stuff. There, yeah, abilities are very instrumental in keeping you alive and helping you take down enemies. Here they're like a bonus. You sort of something you can throw out maybe once during the fight. Okay, coming up on the next research facility in the meanwhile. Oh wow, that was badness. Let's try and be accurate. Okay, good. Let's get into the next area then. Follow me, my friends. I'm gonna grab the sniper rifle for this bit. I think it might be a bit more useful. So, yeah. By the looks of things, yep, same deal. Only those are not little bugs. Those are some things. Those are Thorian creepers. Oh, shite! That was a bug. You got that right. I'll use barrier.
Enemy is everywhere.
What the fuck?
Go, go, go. Enemy is everywhere.
Yeah, and this is chaos, just pure chaos. I mean, there is you have seen, there is a cover system. But
let's head to that next base, Shepard. This is my kind of mission.
Yeah. Yeah, as you can see. Also, this is another slight criticism. You can use the cover-based combat systems to good effect, but the battle lines get so dissolved. I mean, the guys with the guns actually charge you. I mean, that just kind of beats the point of using cover at all. Right, yeah, here's the thing. These medical stations, they're just gonna pump you full of Phoenix armor, which you can sell. If you, for some unknown reason, if you're running out of money, if you can see more, I'm getting Phoenix armor basically for every single race that you can imagine. Now, that does include the Krogan. Enter in. So yeah, I'll just grab all of this stuff and hopefully so I can sell it and get some more cash in. Not that I need it, but yeah. But yeah, what I was saying about Phoenix armor. I mean, you just look at this. So just look at this turd in his pink and white armor. Ashley really is the only person who that armor really suited. Still, I mean, it wasn't that good, to be honest. And yeah, for Liara as well, this armor is not only bad looking, it's also very weak as such. Right. So we have one more research station to go, and apparently, because of the status message, I'm assuming that Admiral Kohoku has been captured by Cerberus, because there was no sign of Kohoku in between the creeper corpses. So I'm assuming he's gonna be in this research facility. So let's head over there and see what we can do. But yeah, there were the little bugs that we encountered in Novaria with the Rachni. Then we had Thorian Creepers. Thorian Creepers. I mean, what else can they have in their labs? Let's find out. Maybe a Rachni Creeper hybrid or something. I mean, he was saying they're kind of making a super soldier. I mean, I think it could be whatever you can imagine. Really. Okay, let's actually check out this anomaly for lols. Okay, oh! That is, by the looks of things, a Prothean pyramid. And I can run up the face. There are a few children's toys and some ragged clothes stuffed inside the top of this monument, along with a Prothean data disk. Shit, but this is cool. Prothean pyramid. Of course, anytime you deal with a mystical, it's gotta be a pyramid. Oh shit, they're actually firing at me. So, yeah, if I would have stood there for a while, I might have gotten hit by some rockets and failed the mission. Speaking of which, actually, that's something I should do. Just for safety. Alright. We done with this? Yeah, we are. Let's save the game. You save. And let's have a look at the squad. I guess more points to be distributed. I'm leveling towards sniper rifles. Liara can work towards her singularity. And Ernot Rex. He can get Master Carnage now. Okay, good. Entering the building now. So let's deal with this last research facility. A bit more stuff in the front room now, but oh, there are actually storage lockers here. One, at least. Bam. Yeah, some pretty standard items, to be honest. Okay. On the ready, my friends. That's the Rachni, and there is someone lying on the floor, and I'm pretty certain I know who it is. Let's get back. Let's make Cerberus deal with the Rachni warrior. Alright, fucking swapping to the pistol. What now? Oh shit, there's more. Apparently there's someone blasting away over here. Yeah, the research technician. Who's a fucking biotic at that? That's just brilliant. That's a sniper. So I'll use my barrier, just in case.
Time to get Kohoku some payback.
Well, there he is. You check for a pulse, but find none. Admiral Koku is dead. Despite the ferocity of the creatures he was sealed in with, there are no signs of trauma on his corpse. The needle marks on his arm suggest a different means of execution.
Oh, Goddess. It's Admiral Koku.
I guess Cerberus found him after all.
Oh, well. Rest in peace, Admiral. At least you let me find out about this facility. Right. I found the location for a major Cerberus facility. Okay, so we're gonna head off to a different planet then. And get their main facility. Frictionless materials. That's a really good one. Really good one. And there's some Predator M armor for Turian. Okay, Garrus is pretty lucky there. And he's actually gonna get a run out in the next mission as well. Because, we will be going to a different planet. Just quickly have a look. Frictionless materials. Damage and heat damping. But can't really use that, to be honest. I mean, I might as well put it in instead of this kinetic stabilizer. So you can just keep on blasting away. I mean, he still can blast away pretty reliably, but he'll be able to do that even better now. Alright, so we're done on this planet. Let's head out. And again, we need to go Columbia system in the Voyager cluster. Oh, okay, so we just need to go to a different system within this cluster. Amazon, and that's Columbia. There we go. Let's see if we can grab some extra stuff from this planet. Samarium, whatever that is. Nepheron, that's the planet where we're gonna be going. Volcanic terrestrial world. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, jovely. Was there some stuff here? Oh no, there wasn't. That was just me. Okay, let's see if there are any flashing lights here. Doesn't look like it. Okay, there's one more planet. League of One medallion. Cool. So, okay, planet Nepheron. Let's roll. I guess I'll take... even though it's... I'll actually go with combat strength this time, and I'll go with Garrus and Ashley. Plus, I won't have to go to their locker to actually give them the best gear that I can provide. Alright, so let's start first with the extra points. Yeah, I suppose I can go do advanced first aid for Ashley. Garrus, meanwhile, is gonna get his master sabotage. And yeah, I've got that maxed out. And in terms of gear, so Ashley. Yeah, this is an improvement, the Predator H8. Very nice. And Garrus, he's got the Predator 9 armor at the moment, but yeah, the Predator M8 is a bit slightly worse for damage protection, but way better for shields and tech and biotic protection. Okay, since this is medium armor, obviously the heavy armor of the human would be preferable. But, still, very good armor. Okay, any weapons that could be useful? Not really. Alright, we're set up, so now we can go and dispose of Cerberus and the disgusting, repulsive facilities. Bits of purple here. And then loads of sun, which is shining somewhere over there. Wow, beautiful. Oh, and I've driven right into the middle of some fucking mountains. Right, let's try and get out of here. Come on, Mako. Come on, buddy. You can do this. There we go. Alright. Yeah, this is gonna be one of our last adventures on the Mako, actually. But yeah, it will still play a major part in one of the main missions, so... Yeah. This is not the last that you'll see of the Mako. Alright, so where are we? Oh, Cerberus. Okay. Hey bro, how you doing? I must die. How about that? That's not a nice thing to say, you know. Alright, that should be everything. Where's that entrance? There it is. Let's clear this shit out. Alright, let's go. Got my, a heavy hitting squad with me now, so yeah, weapons on the ready. Let's go clear out Cerberus. Another scrammer, rank 9. Jesus Christ, these weapon upgrades are sick. So more damage. I'm very appreciative of that. Nothing here. All right, get ready to go in. The worst tactician in fucking history. Alright, move back a bit. Let's pull them in here, into a choke point. Alright, maybe they're not as retarded as I thought. Take her down! Two guys left on their side. There we go. There's a sniper. Oh shit, that was... I just whinge every time. Every time that Carnage shot at me. Because I keep thinking that that could just kill me. Let's pull all this shit up. Okay, so we dealt with that.
Clear.
Yep, it is. So let's move forward. Are there any more Cerberus guys here? Right, some easy decryption stuff. Have some pretty standard gear. Punisher 9 sniper rifle. That could be an improvement for Ashley. Yep, it is. So that's nice. More lockers, more stuff. Crossfire assault rifle. Seems pretty good. Some screens, tables, some scientific equipment by the looks of things. Gonna be some Phoenix armor probably. No, wrong way. And I got stuck. Yep, Phoenix armor, as I said. as I expected, rather. And some sledgehammer and snowblind rounds. Not really useful. Right, final door. Aid station. Nothing else, really. There's a terminal. But, yeah, that's... Okay, you cautiously press a few buttons and an alarm chimes, the optical database flashing itself. Quickly, you copy as many files as you can to your hard suit's internal computer. Its memory wiped, the computer shuts down. The files are sure to be encrypted, but you've got time to crack them. Alrighty then. Yep. Well, I'm not sure about removing a danger that threatened the entire galaxy. I mean, yeah, they were doing experiments, but we don't know to what end, really. All we knew is that they were a block ops organization that was running some experiments. That's it. Admiral Koku knew more, but he didn't really tell us. So, you know, we can't really judge for ourselves what happened. Right. So let's head back to the Normandy and... yeah. And that will be it for that mission. Well, there is one more interaction with this mission.
This mission coming in, Commander. I think you're going to want to hear this one.
Greetings, Commander Shepard. I represent a party interested in obtaining information on Cerberus activities.
Who are you and who do you represent?
Who I am is inconsequential. Suffice to say, I am an agent for the Shadow Broker. You see, Admiral Kahoku contacted my employer looking for information on the location of any Cerberus facilities. We provided that information on the promise that he would turn over copies of all files gathered from the Cerberus systems to us.
Uh-huh.
You must have some connection to Cerberus. How else could you tell Kahoku where to find them?
Information is our business, Commander. Through our contacts, we were able to determine that the Cerberus group was active in the Voyager cluster. Unfortunately, that was all we were able to find out. That is why we are so interested in acquiring copies of the files from you.
Did you have anything to do with Admiral Kahoku ending up dead?
We had no reason to harm him. He was going to provide us with information about Cerberus. Information that is now in your possession.
These are classified Alliance files. I'm not handing them over to you.
Be reasonable, Commander. Cerberus was operating outside Alliance jurisdiction. We don't owe them any loyalty. The Alliance is just going to file this information away in some archive. No secret stays hidden forever. Eventually, someone somewhere will deliver it into our hands. Might as well be you. Transmit the files to us and you will be well compensated.
What are you going to do with this information?
Information is a commodity. It can be bought, sold, or traded. Why my employer desires this information is not my concern. I am only the buyer.
My loyalty is to the Alliance, not the Shadow Broker.
That is unfortunate, Commander. My employer will remember this the next time you need something from us.
Interesting. Alright, so that is it for these missions, and honestly, it's no point going into the Pinnacle Station mission. I mean, I'll go to the system where it's located, but otherwise... Yeah, this is going to be a rather short one, rather short video compared to like all the others I've done recently. But yeah, this is where we're at, Phoenix System in the Argus Row Cluster, and yeah, that's where we're going to do the Pinnacle Station missions, which are a fucking pain in the ass. And after that, after Pinnacle Station, it's all the way to the finish line and the end of the first game. But as for today, that's going to be it. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then feel free to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you leave a like or a comment, that'll be much appreciated. And also don't forget that the channel has Twitter and Facebook pages. Check them out. The links for those can be found in the description of this video. And yeah, that's going to be it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.